Hi everyone, it's Wednesday Warriors and it's me, Arielle, and this week I'm going to be talking about life skills, specifically life skills that you can learn from eating disorder recovery. And the great thing about spinning it that way is that it shows you that through hardships and through struggles, you can actually learn a lot of things that you didn't even set out to learn. So recovery from an eating disorder can teach you things, and these are some of those things. The first life skill is communication. Recovery from an eating disorder teaches you how to have better interpersonal relationships. It teaches you how to communicate effectively, whether it's through email, through letters, through phone calls, and especially person-to-person contact, sitting with someone else, standing with someone else, and having a conversation, having hard conversations, using your voice to not only advocate for yourself, but to express yourself, to be able to say, this is how I feel, this is what I need, this is what I'm asking for. One of the big things that comes to mind when I think of communication as a life skill and recovery from an eating disorder is asking for help. It's really hard for people to ask for help for anyone. But when we think about an eating disorder, asking for help can be a real challenge. So communication is something that we learn when we ask for help, when we put ourselves out there, when we make ourselves vulnerable, and we state plain and simple, this is what I need from you. And it's a very important skill because if you can learn to ask for help when you need it, to push through the fear that you might feel, to make your needs known, and to express yourself in whatever way that might mean, you have so much going for you for any other hardships that you may encounter in life once your eating disorder is part of your past. The second skill is self-care. Self-care is a word that people tend to know what it means, but they're not always able to readily come up with examples as far as what constitutes self-care. But being in eating disorder recovery can not only promote self-care, but it can teach you self-care. It can teach you how to know yourself better, how to recognize what you need, and how to give yourself those things when you need them. Self-care can mean eating meals. Self-care can mean a hot bath after a long day. Self-care can mean journaling. It can mean art. It can mean a phone call to a friend. It can mean snuggling with pets. Self-care can mean rewarding yourself, whether it's with tangible items, you know, material items, or whether it's with something that's a little bit more abstract. Self-care is completely different for every person. Self-care is about understanding what is vital and important and nourishing to your body, mind, and spirit. Self-care is a very important life skill because as things happen in our lives, which certainly they will need to use self-care. And if we don't know how to self-care, we are going to face challenges that seem greater than we are. And we're not going to know how to provide ourselves with stress relief or coping mechanisms that are healthy when we need to. The third life skill is a positive attitude. And I know many people wouldn't consider a positive attitude or a positive outlook to be a form of a life skill. But for me, it's definitely a life skill. And I think it's a life skill worth learning because the right attitude can really set the framework for your life. It can set the tone for your whole day. It can impact your mood in ways that you don't always realize. Having the right attitude can not only change how you see yourself, but it can change your interactions with other people. Whether those people are someone you're going to be meeting for 5 minutes out of your day, like the postman or someone at a store, or people that you work with on a regular basis, or your family members that you see all the time, constantly. When you recover from an eating disorder, having an attitude of hope, having an attitude that's positive, that propels you forward towards your goal, is something that doesn't leave you very easily. And that's a great thing because, again, as you continue through life, as things happen, especially things that are out of your control, having that positive attitude is going to be your armor. And it's also going to be that tool that you can pull out when you need it. When nothing else works, you can, at the very least, have a positive attitude. And having that positive attitude will give you a leg up. And the last life skill I'm going to talk about today is how to look within. I think the ability to look within is a life skill. And the reason I think recovery from an eating disorder helps with this is the more you learn yourself, the more you are able to have insight into your own life, into your own feelings, into your own thoughts. And that's important because the more you know yourself, the more you can understand why you do the things you do and what you want out of life, and even more so, what you don't want out of life. And it seems very simple, but tons of people don't know what they want out of life, and they don't know what they don't want out of life. They never bother to ask the very important questions. Recovery from an eating disorder causes us to look within because we're forced to face some things that we might not otherwise face. And in choosing to face those things, we have not only self-determination, but we become very self-aware. And self-awareness is one of the most vital mechanisms that you can employ because it causes you to see yourself through a new lens, through a real lens, and it causes you to live your life in a different way and take care of yourself better and take responsibility for yourself. And the other reason why I think being able to look within is an important life skill that recovery from an eating disorder can teach you is it teaches us to look past appearances. And that's very important, not only with ourselves, but with other people. If we can learn to, as we meet other people, see them for the person they really are and not for how pretty they are, how handsome they are, how thin they are, how fit they are, how good their hair looks, how great their skin is, or how bad any of those things might be too. It's deeper. It's about knowing people on a deeper level, bothering to know them on a deeper level, and using that kind of interaction to make your life better. When you're able to see people as more than just their appearance, and you're able to see yourself as more than just the way you look, you are allowing yourself to be a whole person. And you are allowing other people to be able to be themselves and their whole person as well. And I don't want to say it makes the world a better place, but it really does make the world a better place because you are being real and you're asking for reality in return. And you're not fooling yourself into thinking that beauty, or I should say society's concept of beauty, is the most important thing, because it's not. I hope you all have a wonderful week, and I will see you next time.